guys, how's it going? Lady Survival here. I just wanted to make a quick video today because I haven't made one at home in my usual, like, let's sit down on my bed and just ramble about whatever. As you guys can probably tell, I have a new hair color and I really, really love it. I just did this yesterday and I think it looks really, really awesome. So basically, I had red hair for a while and then I decided, screw it, I'm done with the red. It doesn't really suit me as well as, like, purple and stuff, because I feel like with my skin tone, like being very pale, purple is just a really good color. So that was like a month or two ago. I faded out the red as much as I could, and then I just put like a dark purple over top and it covered, thank God. I really, really loved that purple for a while, and then over time I was just kind of like, you know what, I really miss like having silver hair. So I started to try to fade the purple out, and I got the purple to like a pretty faded color. I was using like Head and Shoulders to like faded out as much as I could, and then I got my hair to this kind of like, I think because there was like red underneath of the purple, as I was fading it, it was turning more like to the pink side instead of like a faded purple version, and a lot of like red orangey tones were coming through, so I was kind of like, shit, I don't really like this. So I kept trying to like tone it with like Manic Panic Ultraviolet mixed in with conditioner as like kind of like a purple to cover up the red orangey tones. I literally don't know, it was just kind of random. And then I had this kind of rose gold pink color for a little bit and I liked it. At first I was like, wow, I feel like a pastel like queen or something. And then I was like, after a little bit, I really hate the color pink, like personally, even though I have a pink pillow right there and there. But just personally, I'm not a huge fan of it. So after a couple days of having that, I was like, I really don't like having pink toned hairs. I went ahead and I bought the Blue Steel hair dye by Manic Panic, which is supposed to be kind of like good for like silver hair. And I was like, okay, well, my hair is like pretty light, I'll like wet it and put on like the Blue Steel over top of wet hair to kind of tone it in a way, and hopefully like it'll turn kind of silver. I don't really know, but it didn't really work. Like, it wasn't a dark enough color to cover the color that my hair was, so that was kind of a fail. And then I was like, you know what, I feel like I have Arctic Fox Transylvania, which is like a black hair dye, but when you dilute it, it's like a blue based black color, so it turns like blue. And I was like, you know what, I can dilute the Transylvania a bit and like it'll be a kind of a more intense version of Manic Panic Blue Steel. I don't know if any of this makes sense, and I don't even know how I got into this deep of a hair ramble, but I just want to tell you guys like how I got this color because I think it's pretty awesome. So yeah, I diluted the Arctic Fox Transylvania and it was kind of like a darkish blue color sort of thing, and then I just put it over top, and this is the color that I got. I really love it. And for my extensions, what I've been doing recently to dye them, and it's so much easier, and I highly encourage anyone who has extensions to do this, is instead of like actually brushing on the hair dye onto the extensions, I fill up like the sink, or you could use a bowl, like whatever, just fill up something with like water and just add a few drops of the color that you want it to be and just swish it around, so you just have like colored water basically, and then you just like submerge the extensions in and let them sit for a little bit, and it just like absorbs the color. Like, these were completely pinky purple and they took the blue like pretty well. So worst case, I do at some point think I might just go to the salon and get her to bleach out my hair, because I also haven't done my roots in like a really long time. Like, they are super super duper long. I don't know if you can see, but it's like a good like 3 or 4 inches, and I don't know, I kind of like the roots, but at the same time, like, I'd like to just have uniform color, and I also need a trim anyway, so I might just go and be like, hey, let's bleach my hair and give myself a trim and all that stuff, because my real hair is probably about like this length right here. Let me just like grab a piece. This is a piece of my real hair, so it's like kind of growing, but at the same time it's like at the ends they're very like split and stuff, so I need to get a trim so I can continue growing it. I would like to get to a point where I don't have to wear extensions, and holy cow, I feel like I literally just talked about my hair for so long, but I just figured some of you might be curious how I got this color, and yeah, so that's kind of my little journey from like red hair to dark purple to faded purple to kind of this weird pink color to now this bluey silver mess. Also, another thing I did want to mention, I don't know if you guys can see, but I have this little Medusa piercing on my lip here. Not real, I have been gluing a little piercing ball to that spot for the last couple days and just like wearing it like to work or like wherever I go, I just like wear it for the whole day. Like it doesn't fall off. I just use like eyelash glue and it stays there as long as I don't like specifically like pull it off, but like I can eat stuff and like talk through the day and it won't fall off. And like I think that I really like it and I do want to go get it pierced. I've just been wearing it to kind of see like if I do really like it, and I do really like it. Like when I'm not wearing it, I'm like, what the hell, like put the ball back on. So I'm probably going to get it pierced super soon. I'm just like trying to not spend my money, so I don't really want to drop like $80 on a piercing, but also I do really badly. So what do you guys think? Do you like the Medusa piercing on me? Do you think I should get rid of like my snake bites or anything? Like I don't really know. I feel like I like having a lot of face piercings, so I'll probably just do it. That's pretty much exciting stuff, hair stuff, piercing stuff in my life. Also, I did, I've made posts about this on Instagram and Snapchat and stuff, but if you guys watched my video about how I lost my favorite World of Warcraft hoodie, I did find one online. Let me just wear it. What am I trying to do? So I have been posting about it everywhere being like, oh my god, I miss my hoodie. Like if anyone can find a website that sells it, please let me know. And one of my followers did find a website, and the website was called Sweatshirt XY, and it was interesting because I've ordered off, which I'm guessing is the same company. I ordered off a company before called T-Shirt XY, and I got like a Sylvanas shirt. So it was kind of cool. Like I was like, wow, how did I not hear of this? But this is the hoodie. Let me reposition myself. This is what it looks like. I feel like it is pretty on point to the original design. Like the image looks exactly the same. It's the same quality. The hoodie is a little bit more of like a thicker kind of material. Like I feel like the other one's kind of more like slightly more thin. Like it's still, both were high quality, but this one's just like a different brand of hoodie and it feels kind of thicker, which I guess is good. And I got a size medium, and I'm like 5'2", 5'3"-ish, and I weigh like 105 pounds, if that helps any of you. And I really like the sizing. If I got a small, I would have been upset. If I got a large, it probably would have been too big, so medium was a perfect option for me. I really, really love it. It's like, I have not worn it ever since I got it, and it's been like a week or two, and I just have worn it every single day. I love it so, so, so much. It did end up costing me, like with the, I think it was like a European site or something weird, or maybe, I don't know, it was something, it had to convert to Canadian, and then I had to pay for the shipping, and by the end I spent like $108 on it, which for me is totally worth it. If you want this hoodie, I would highly recommend doing it. The only other thing I'll mention is that the printed design feels kind of like shiny or glossy, and like I'm kind of scared to wash it. Like I'm not sure what will happen. Like I feel like there's potential that it could kind of flake off or even like melt off a little bit, so I'm really kind of scared. But as I've been wearing it more, the glossy feeling has kind of been going away, so like it might be okay, and I can give you guys like an update on what happens when I wash it. But I'm gonna try to go as long as I can without doing that because I'm just nervous. But I honestly love it so much. I would highly recommend getting it if you're into World of Warcraft and stuff, because it's the only site on all of the internet where you can find this anymore. Like, I looked everywhere and this was the only site where they had it. I tried contacting Jinx and they were like, no, like, we'll never make it again. So, like, if you want it, I'd suggest getting it, because you never know if this site will stop too. So yeah, that is my little update on everything. I'm sorry this was a very, like, rambly video and everything, but I hope that you guys have a wonderful, wonderful day, and I will talk to you all again very, very soon. Thank you guys so much for watching. Bye, guys!